Debbie had asked me how she could take her multiple flower exposure and merge it with the single exposure so she could have only the middle part of the flower in focus. This video was on the Macro Chat live show. If you're interested in watching the show that has a lot more information, go down below and I'll link it to the show. So let's get to it. So she wants this part to pop out of this image right here. So there's always several ways to do one thing, but let's go ahead and click over here to the move tool. And I'm going to just hold on to it and drag it over to this guy right in here. And I'm still holding my mouse down. I'm going to hit the shift button and let go. And over here to the right, what I'll end up doing is going back and forth, just making sure, is it lined up? If I see a little jump, say in the middle, as I'm going back and forth, then go ahead and hit the controller command key and make sure that both of the layers are selected. And then you'll go over to edit, and then you're going to click on auto align layers. And I'll just do that and see what it does. Here's my auto align. I'll just do the auto and we'll see what it does. I'm curious. Now it's aligned perfectly. So if it wasn't, you would see a mask over here to the right and would align it. So everything's good. We don't need to worry about it. What I'm going to do is do a command J, or you can drag the bottom layer. Doesn't matter which layer you want to work off of. Just know that the top layer here is the layer that is the most important because that's what we see. So if I uncheck it, then I'm only seeing the two layers below. People have always asked me, why do you always keep a second layer at the bottom? It's just for me. So if I do the Alt and Option and I want to go back to this file, then I can go back to it. So if you don't want to look at this one, then you would obviously have, say, this file. We'll delete this and we will go ahead and add this file down. So we'll leave it at that. It's not a big deal. I'm going to now work on this top image. So it's easier because what I want to do is get up really close and look at her image, and she wants all of this to be in focus. She said the middle part. And in order to do that, we have to make a mask. And in order to make a mask really goes with tones, and tones is colors and all this stuff, technical stuff. Listen, let's not even go into the technical stuff. You just want to make sure that everything in the middle is masked. So we're going to do first a mask, and it's not going to be perfect. Okay, so we're just going to do something really fast, and we're just going to go around in circles and just click in here. Oops, I do want that part right there, but oh well, we'll just leave it like that. Okay, so that's just a basic mask. Just make it easy at first. Don't get too technical because you have a lot of yellows and everything. So we just want to work with this area in here. So I just circled that. I'm going to click down here at the bottom and make a quick mask right here. And now you could see I've made the mask, and now I can see only the middle part of this flower right here. You could see it selected with the white. So that is only showing the middle part, but I want to really refine this area. So what we'll do is double click, and we're going to go to select the mask. We could use color range also, but let's try selecting a mask first. Gives me to this whole new pane, which is pretty cool. I love it. So over here to the right side has a lot of great tools in here. So you could see onion style. There's so many different ways you could look at this to really hone in on what you are shooting for. I want to do the refine mask. And I'm going to get in here. and paint in everything that I want masked. And it does this, it's a smart brush. A lot of the programs, I'm in Photoshop, but there are tons, actually On1 has the best when it comes to masking. Whew, I love On1, they just are so good when it comes to masking. So something like this that's kind of complicated because of the colors, I may just take it into On1, but not everybody has On1. So my suggestion is to take your time. Let's just get in close so you can really see what you're doing. Over here to the right is the smoothing and the feathering amount if you want all that. This shift edge is really good for landscape, but not here. I don't think we need it. Let's see. Oh wait, no. Yeah, no, I don't want to shift that. Okay, over here to the right where it says output settings, this right here is where I want you to pay attention to. Do you want a layer mask, selection, new layer? I'm just going to do a layer mask. So we'll leave it on that. And then I'll push OK. So here's the before. And here is the after. Bam! Doesn't that look pretty? Thank you again, Debbie.